clock set to kick off. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Johnson has the ball teed up, and we're just about ready to get this one started. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 26. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he's tackled around the 26-yard line.
Defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. Here's a handoff left side. He's tackled at the 41-yard line.
It's a great play by the defense, but it really makes you wonder, was there a miscommunication up front by the offensive line? They just seemed to allow the defensive line to get through, and the running back didn't have much of a chance at all.
He's scrambling, and he's going to be sacked.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. He wants it all.
I'd go right back to him. He's got the skills to make things happen, and the defense might not be able to keep up at this moment.
It's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. And they get nice yardage on that run. Williams gains around 5 yards on the draw play from scrimmage. Here's the eighth play of the series. Six. So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. Tackle at the 5. A 1 yard gain by the halfback. This will make it a field goal game. The kick is up, and he got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Taylor fields it at the 1. And he's tackled at the 33. The the Tigers and talking with them this week, Kirk. It's just interesting their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself. And I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. The coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas on the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen in a long time where he just wants to have a chance to have an impact on the game and on the outcome. And I'll be shocked if they can slow him down.
The running back gets a yard, maybe less. Third and 10, ball on the 33-yard line. And he hits him hard at the 26-yard line.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. The offense gets set to take the field. Last time out, they stuck it between the uprights for three. Tries to buy some time. Slides down. Good game there on the quarterback scramble.
You know, I really like the decision to tuck it and run here. He waited and found no one open, so instead of throwing it away, he just took it upfield for himself.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He's on the run. Slides down to the ground.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
Second down, 14 coming up here. Ball on the 43. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
An exciting first quarter comes to an end. The score here in Houston is the Mavericks 3, the Tigers nothing. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. They'll give it off here. And he's stopped behind the line.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Handoff, brought down quickly. This is the eighth play of the drive. He heaves it to the end zone. Knocked down, incomplete.
There was definitely an opening for the quarterback to try to squeeze that pass in, but it was just a terrific play by the safety to prevent that touchdown.
So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. It has the distance. And he splits the uprights. They're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Room around the corner. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He makes it to the 28-yard line. We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 28. The offense going to try to open this field up, coming out in a five-wide set. And the defense counters with their dime look. Locked down at the 46.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
First and 10, ball on the 46. He makes it to the 48-yard line.
That's a gain of two. That makes it second and eight.
Quick throw. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. That's a great tackle at the 22-yard line.
Well, they found some seams in the coverage there. Let's see if the defense makes any adjustments to counter.
From the 22-yard line, it's first down.
Tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
And he almost has the INT.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 10-yard line. They go with the back, and he's hammered in the backfield. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Fourth and long here after the sack. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20, heading for the corner, and down he goes at the 26.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a t-shirt that says finish, finish, whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to their opponent's territory.
He's going to try and scramble. Room around the corner. He decides to run with it. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Man, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
From their own 46-yard line. First down.
46-yard line.
Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback. The offense calls a timeout, and they'll have two remaining. Caught, open field, knocked out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. And he just gets rid of it. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. And he's immediately tackled. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. And they make the stop around the 24-yard line. Shot, the defender tips it away. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so much separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Strike complete. And he's tackled at the 33-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Once and all, going deep.
Super effort to get the ball and knock it away. Real good job down the field.
Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
Here we go. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. Gets it. He's in space. Lost the ball. Fumble. And no one can get it. It bounces out of bounds. Yard line. Second down. Slings it. He's tackled at the 47-yard line. Throws and it's incomplete. A great first half comes to a close. The score here in Houston is the Mavericks 6, the Tigers 3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Tackle made at the 16. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He chucks it downfield. And a great catch for the 20, the 10, and a huge touchdown play. That last catch gives him 100 yards receiving.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
Teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Broke away from one, and he's tackled at the 25.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
And he's taken down. 22.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved them back.
Second and 13. Ball on the 22-yard line. Five wide.
Here we go.
Scrambling around.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 40-yard line.
Here we go.
Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Now he's scrambling. For extra yardage. And he has a huge game.
Yeah, I like the decision-making ability of this quarterback. He looks and looks. He sees nothing. He didn't get rattled. He sees some green in front of him, and he takes off. Ends up with a great run.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 49.
Good outside run there.
Up about 4 yards on the play. This is the eighth play of this drive. They'll bring him down right around the 38-yard line. From the 38-yard line, first down.
The defense just met the blockers head on and drove them back straight into the runner.
10th play of the drive. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Tackle made around the 33-yard line. They've looked good so far on third down in this drive. Let's see what happens here. He scrambles. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. He's at the 20. And down he goes at the 20-yard line. This is the 12th play of this drive. Pressure, and he can't get away from the pressure.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20. The 14th play of the drive. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
First and goal from the 5. They're knocking on the door. Quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. Trying to go up by 3. They'll kick the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Boy, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting. The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
Makes it out to about the 33.
That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Here we go. Check, check. 98 Razor. 98.
Quick pass. Intercepted. Brought down at the 42-yard line.
Really impressed with this guy's closing speed on the ball. He's got the kind of jets you need to be a standout corner.
From the 42-yard line, it's first down. Fires incomplete.
That would have been a great play if the throw were just a little bit more on target.
To the halfback on the screen. He's tackled in the open field. from the 29-yard line. First down. Great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. The score here in Houston is the Mavericks 13, the Tigers 10. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. He fights forward to about the 19. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. And he's tackled right away.
That's a key play to find the open man and keep the drive alive.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12-yard line. They'll keep it on the ground again. He gets out to about the 12-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. For his running back, incomplete. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. Kicks up, and it is good. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. He's taken down at the 25-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 25. They make the stop at about the 21. The D lineman wasn't letting anyone by him that time.
And the big fella did a heck of a job plugging up the hole where that play was supposed to go.
Pressure coming. Looks quick to his tight end, and he can't hang on. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. He makes it out to midfield. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. From the 37-yard line, first down.
throws it deep. And he hauls it in deep downfield.
White out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
Once he gets those jets on, there wasn't going to be anything that could stop him. And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. They got it. A quick two-play, 50-yard drive, and they add 8 points to their total. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. I tell you, you've got to tip your hat to the defense. They played well today.
Well, this defense has done everything that's asked of them. They've slowed down the opposing offense. They've created turnovers. They've got pressure on the quarterback. In these last couple drives, they just played probably the best they've played all game.
The defense shut them down on their last drive, forcing a quick punt. Passes to the left, and it's going the other way. And he's tackled at about the 31.
The quarterback has made some really careless throws, but you got to also give credit to the defense for being able to clean up the mess and create the turnovers.
We've got a first and 10, ball on the 31-yard line. He's tackled at the 29-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
He's at the 20. Gets out to around the 18.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? You better be thanking his offensive lineman for that.
From the 18-yard line, it's first down. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. Gain of 6.
Tight end does a good job here of selling his block and then getting out on his route and making a nice catch for a good game.
He tackles him for a loss.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. Run to the outside. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Here's the 8th play of the series. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee. The Tigers, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. And next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.